Yo, what's happening? This channel's been out there, just started uploading all the footage. I got a lot of content coming up. Be patient with us. This is episode number one. Here we go. Good morning, everybody. My name is Kazi. I have my boy Mark working out here with us. If you want to follow his story, follow his life, follow his journey, I'll have his Instagram on this episode. If not, we're going to get the other episode. I'll have that for you. Today was a crazy leg workout day. This is actually super light for him. Granted that he's just coming back. But I've seen him squats and heavy duty stuff. Anyways, if you don't want to watch the video, go all the way at the end. We have some fast forward all the way at the end. We've got some motivation stuff for you guys. Some topics to talk about. Give me some feedback. Let me know what you guys think.
Yeah, you went all the way.
Fuck. Yeah, it's all turning. Yeah.
That's just like
it's gonna fly you. Me up. Yeah, I know.
Yep.
Right, you're hanging out with your boys. Now when women get cheated on and they get fucked up, instantaneously their first response is, I'm gonna find someone better to make him fucking jealous, to realize what he fucking lost. We fucking go, how do I make myself better? What did I do? Why did she fucking act like that? Why are we always arguing? as a human male, we statistically always look at our opinion before we look at the women's. That's why I'm saying when women get fucked over, they want to fuck over 10 billion fucking dudes because of one guy. If a guy gets fucked over, we fucking separate from that fucking love, right, bro, right, because right. We fucking don't want to fucking go through that bitch again.
So how do you, so for the next woman, how do you, like,
you
because
don't.
Then you're like just, yes, you sit in your feelings, you kind of like move forward, like, okay, you know what, you sit in it, you accept it, that happened, you move forward. How do you necessarily, like, okay, the next woman is not going to be like that.
You become a better man for yourself. It's like you've always told me, if no one can like you for who you are, then just better yourself.
Mm.
We're not here to impress nobody, and if they don't like it, then fuck it. The only person here that we're really in competition with is ourselves.
I agree with that part. But I guess my question was like, how
do you kind of
like the woman do that? Because women have dealt with so many guys who are assholes and, you know, jerks and stuff.
But
and
it
when
falls
get
to
a good guy.
But it falls to the same topic
because
of like women are selective, but they're still selecting assholes. And they
it's true. Okay, so but then what happened when the good guy comes around? So like,
they don't
then
care.
they're like, well, hold on, I'm just waiting for him to mess up.
They don't care. They don't care.
So you just, what, you just walk away?
Yeah. Like I said, you just try to be a better human being for yourself and just try to find yourself mentally, because you're going to keep killing yourself trying to find love. That's finding love, mate. Now you're fucking looking to see what, see? Now, it goes on to what I said, the similarities, because now you're comparing, like, what if you did this? See? Like, that's what I mean. You're looking for that now.
Just, but isn't that the whole goal, though, ultimately goal? Like, ultimate goal is to look for love at the end?
Because no.
You want to expand. I guess you want to get better, you want to make yourself better, right? No doubt. But you want to eventually find love and family and etc.
It's kind of that topic of like how we always talk about, like, what do you find in a, what do you want to find in a woman? Well, I want her to be ambitious, I want her to do this, I want her to do that. And you know, it's like, it, and that's like what I'm saying, like, and it's like how people talk about online, when a woman makes more money than a man, they don't look at us, mate. They just go, what do you have to offer? I'm better than you, I achieved what you thought you couldn't achieve.
But they, I don't,
and then when a man does it, when a man makes the same income, a woman goes, that's it. When they don't make shit,
no, I agree
that's
with
it.
That.
So I look at it this way, mate. We're put on this world, like Chad said, the world's a double standard, hella double standard now. People are so sensitive. Now you got to look at it to where it's like, fuck. Just don't give a fuck. Just really just
fall out of the system. I feel like we can't really lose that side of our, like,
you can't, because
it loses
the love. But at the same time, that masculinity,
yes, you're protecting yourself,
that masculinity now in today's generation is so fucking diminished and destroyed. There's so many people online talking about, we don't care if you're fucking posing with your shit. And that's why there's so many videos like, we don't fucking care, we don't do it for you. Why are you talking shit? Like, why? Where did that topic come from? Last year, everyone was posting like, yeah, gym this, gym that. Now, this year, all I see is no one fucking cares. Why are you fucking posting? You think we like you guys? Fucking shut up.
Yeah.
Shut up. Why are you always judging us? I'm not saying men don't judge women, but we do it on a very digress level to where they don't even know we're judging them. When women judge us,
I feel like
that's
everybody judges, bro. I think everybody judges. You know how they say, don't judge a book by its cover?
That's what
it's
saying,
actually,
but like,
so wrong.
But it's different. Like, we now, do. We're judging people privately. Women will judge you publicly and not give a fuck.
And women don't even make that decision. Like, I came across this one video. The woman, they don't even make a decision. They're not very decision-maker. What they do is they ask their homegirl, hey, what do you think about that guy?
Yep.
You know? Opposed to us, we're like, we don't give a fuck what our homie think. We're just going to, you know,
yep,
we're going to go talk to them.
Yep. But, I mean, that's what I'm saying. Just, there's that. This shit's kind of breaking. It's weird.
I don't know,
there's
but that, I kind of want, like, I like those submissive women, you know? But not necessarily submissive, like, intimacy wise, like submissive in a way where you, like, you do things for your partner. Like, in our culture, it's already given.
Yeah,
like, it's fucking given. Like, literally,
like,
not even doubt.
One of the biggest things that I learned is when I would be in a relationship, you know what I used to do? I would show them my pay stub, and it was great because I seen someone else say this online. I would show them my pay stub because it's not what I can offer to the table. Because, like, if I, this is one thing I noticed. My grandparents did the same thing because, you know, we were so tight with money. So my grandma would want nice things, but my grandpa would just be like, here's the check. Here's my check for 2 weeks.
But see, you can't really
and
do that now.
No, well.
To a right woman, yes, but not to, like you would think she's a potential.
See, so there,
like,
it is. Or, there it is. Now you're worried about your income and now you're worried about her opinion. See, that's what I'm talking about.
No, but like, see, the thing is that the woman's going to be like, well, this nigga can't even, you know, he can't even afford, like.
That's a double standard I'm talking about. So why should we give a fuck? If they're gonna judge us already like that, why should we?
Like my family, like they do. Like my dad, Like, anything that he gets, like, he, you know, shows.
Yeah, because it puts you in that position, like, oh, fuck, this is what we really have. This is what we can afford. I might make the money, but my girl pays the bills. So she knows how much I'm really making. So she knows how much she can fucking spend and how much I can spend. Like I said, mate, when it becomes a two-person party, I'm not fighting for just me now. I'm fighting for us. So I need you with that understanding. I can only make ends meet with this much. Now help me. And if you're not willing to help me, then you don't give a fuck about me.
But I feel like that is,
because now,
like,
we're not working together. Now you want me to work for you. You want me to work for your entertainment, for your surplus. I'm
that's
trying
selfish.
To work
I get
for
it.
Sustainability yeah, for
I,
both
I,
of us.
I get that. That's selfish. But I feel like you cannot get to that level until later into the stage. You can't just be like, well, we're living together, we moved in together, I'm like, hey babe, I'm
no, but that's what I'm saying there. I'm not saying in the beginning, but I'm saying, like, that's what I mean. Like, you can't just, but you can't also portray yourself as that guy in the beginning, because
yes,
then you put yourself in an expectancy.
Exactly,
it's like,
yes, no, I get
mate,
it.
No, fuck that.
You're exactly.
I'm 100%, I'll tell the female on the first date, hey, we splitting a check, baby. I'm not taking you home. We this is a first date. We having a conversation. Like,
a first date shouldn't
even
be on a dinner, bro. I feel like first date should always be like
hang out and
get to another person.
But
like,
no, like, you
women
know what
are
I mean
just
by
so entitled,
like,
oh,
go
you know
out
what?
For the night. Like,
yeah.
Let's go out for the night. But like, that's what I mean. Like, there's, why is it every
and then
man?
What do you think about the when it comes to like whoever takes, like whoever offers, like, hey, you know what? Let's go out here. Do you think that person should pay?
Yes.
Right? Okay.
You invited me out,
yeah,
motherfucker. Exactly. Like, I didn't want to go out. I wanted to stay home and save money. And your ass is like, let's go to the fucking Hilton this weekend. Motherfucker, you better have Hilton money if it was your idea. Like, my idea is I'm going to cook dinner at home with a steak and fucking we have some candlelight and I'll throw a fucking Netflix on. I can't afford this shit.
I always feel like, bro, the first date should be like something. Because you, okay, I feel like if you try to get to know the person, you have to be able to get to know them in an environment where, like, it's over dinner, you can't really get to know them.
Yeah.
Isolate yourself and, you know, get to know them. Because what if after the first meeting, you're like, no. You can be attractive.
See, that's what I'm saying.
But you can't be attractive mentally.
That is fair. That's actually a good one. See, I wouldn't know how to go about that because, I mean, I don't know.
And a lot of people
I'm personally
like, well,
an asshole.
Take me? Oh,
I'm not the cutest son of a bitch, but you know, hey, the females, I stay away from the females, guys, but the females can't stay away from me. I'm like, shit. You get me, especially in the gym. You see me, like, you know, you see me put down on the splits and I'm just, yeah. Like, but no, like, that's, I don't know. It's the world we live in today is, there's so many things that's so questionable that's like, I don't even want to fucking talk about certain things because we might get canceled.
Sensitive.
But, you know, like, hey. But good TED Talk. I have to go.
All right, mate. Well,
we're going to keep this up. We'll
yes.
have episode
tomorrow.
Number. Yeah, tomorrow.
Episode number two.
Tomorrow. Episode number two. Continuation episode.
All right, mate.
It's 10:40. I'm going to be home at like 11:10. I'm supposed to leave my house at 11:20. I'm going to drive to school. My hair.
I'm going to get a burrito, bro.
I know, huh? Be safe, mate. I'll see you tomorrow.
Yeah, I'm going to get out.